In this video, we cover working with the just-in-time compiler. First, we change to the directory that contains the source code which you downloaded for the book. Next, we start the Docker containers running. We then will shell into the PHP 8 container. Inside the container, we change to the slash repo directory, which is mapped to the host source code directory on your host computer. Now we need to check to see if opcache is enabled. We examine the php.ini file. Notice at the top, zend extension equals opcache. Also notice opcache.enable and enable underscore CLI. We created a program that changes opcache settings for the purposes of the JIT demo. The program is PHP 8 JIT reset in the ch10 directory. Notice the usage. We will now use this reset program to turn off JIT. Notice the opcache settings, JIT off, buffer size 0. The test program implements a Mandelbrot. Maximum loops is set to 10,000. The Mandelbrot implementation was created by Dimitri, one of the developers of the PHP language. We now execute the Mandelbrot implementation from the browser. We can use localhost 8888 for our URL. We cut the video short because of the time length. Notice at the bottom, without JIT, the time is 26.992 seconds. Let's now use one of the older JIT modes, which is the function mode. We use the reset program to change the mode. Notice now the opcache JIT settings function, buffer size of 64 meg. We refresh the page and observe the time. However, we do need to restart PHP FPM to get the full benefit. we return to the browser and refresh the page. Notice, even though we're using the older function setting, the time is 2.289 seconds. Let's now try the newer tracing mode. Notice the settings are now set to tracing. We then restart PHP FPM. The first time we refresh, JIT does some caching. The time factor is better than without JIT, but not so good as function. We refresh the page again. You'll notice the time has dropped to 0.529 seconds. When we reset the program to off, it also re-enables xdebug. This is explained in more detail in the notes. Returning to the notes page, if you go down to the bottom, there's an explanation of a bug introduced in PHP 8.0.1. where there's a conflict between any extension that executes Zend execute EX and the JIT. Also, please don't forget to buy the book. Thank you for watching.